Hello students, welcome in our new session of lesson Fair Play. This is our question and answer session, and let's see the remaining questions of this lesson. Okay, let's start. Question number one: replace the italicized portion of each sentence below with a suitable phrase from the box. Make necessary changes whenever required. Students, here you have to look the italic portion of each sentence, and then you have to replace that phrases with the one given in a box. Okay, students, and then we will make necessary changes along it too, right? So let's see, first of all, what are the italic parts of in a given sentence. The first sentence: the best way to avoid an unnecessary argument is to remain silent. So to remain silent is a phrase, and instead of this phrase you have to place another phrase from the given box, the phrases in the given box, right, students? So we will see the changes after reading the all sentences. Okay, students. Okay, let's see. Unfortunately, the train I was trying to catch was cancelled. Here, unfortunately is the word which was italic. He has been told not to take risk while driving a car through a crowded street. So to take risks is a italic portion. We have to find out the another phrase with the same meaning. Okay, then look at the fourth one. The patient needs to be properly taken care of. Taken care of is the another phrase. Why don't the two of you end your quarrel by shaking hands? So end your quarrel by shaking hands is the another phrase. I was in difficult situation till my friends came to my rescue. When I saw the pile of dirty dishes, I felt very disappointed is the another phrase. Then I will examine the matter carefully before the commenting on it. So examine is the another word. Then they criticize him in the meeting, but he accepted without protest all the criticism. So accepted without protest is the italic part of the sentence. It will free me from worry to know that I had done nothing wrong. So free me from worry is the phrase. And then let's see what changes we have to do instead of the word italic in above sentences. Students, in the first sentence we have seen that the word which is italic is the word remain silent. The word which is italic is remain silent, and the proper word in the favor of that phrase is to keep mum. So the whole sentence is became like this. The best was to avoid an unnecessary argument is to keep mum. To keep mum, it means remains silent. Okay, students. Then in second sentence, the word which was actually italic is unfortunately, and for unfortunately the another phrase which is used is as ill luck would have it. As ill luck would have it. Okay, then in a third sentence the phrase which was italic is not to take risk, and correct phrase for it is not to take chance. So sentence will become like this. He has been told not to take chances while driving a car through a crowded street. Then after, look at that fourth one. The patient needs to be properly care of. Taken care of. Taken care of, it the same meaning is look after. Taken care of means look after. So the sentence is became like this. The patient needs to be properly taken care of. Okay, look at that fifth one. why don't the two of you, why don't the two of you end your quarrel by shaking hands? So end your quarrel by shaking hands is the italic phrase, and we have to replace it by another phrase, and the replacing phrase is make it up by shaking hands. So make it up is the another phrase. Okay, then look at that sixth one. I was in a tight spot till my friends came to my rescue. So here a tight spot is the phrase which is replace difficult situation. So difficult situation is replaced by tight spot, right? Then in 7 you can see, when I saw a pile of dirty dishes my heart sank. So my heart sank, it is used for felt very disappointment or felt very disappointed. Okay, then in a eighth sentence, look at that. I will go into the matter. So go into the matter is the phrase, it is used to replace the phrase examine. It is replaced to use the phrase examine. Then in a ninth one, they criticize him in the meeting, but he accepted without protest. So he accepted without protest is the actual phrase, and it is replaced by swallowed all the criticism. Then look at that question number 10. it will free me from worry to know that I had done nothing wrong. Free me from worry, the replace phrase is conscience to know. It will ease one's conscience to know that I had done nothing wrong. Okay, like that you can replace all the phrases as given in the video. Okay, then look at that question number B. Look at the following phrases and their meanings. Use the phrases to fill in the blanks in the sentence given below. Okay, let's see what are the phrases and their meanings are given. Set up means put in place of or start. Then set aside means save or keep for a particular purpose. Look at that third one. Set down means write or record. Set out, it means start on a journey. Set in means begin and seem likely to continue. Okay students, then now we have to use the given phrases in the given sentences. Okay, let's see. The answers are given here directly. You can see, just answer directly. Why don't you dot dot your ideas on paper? So the correct answer is, why don't you set down? Set down means write. Why don't you set down your ideas on paper? Look at that second. A fund has been dot dot for the soldiers' families. A fund has been set up. Set up means put in place or put for. Start for. The fund has been start for, like this. So set up for the soldiers' family. Look at that third one. We should dot dot a little money every month. We should dot dot a little money every month. And the correct phrase is we should set aside. Set aside means, yes, save a little money for every month. Look at that fourth one. You should buy some woolens before winter set in. You should buy some woolens before winter set in. Here, set in. Set in means begin and seem likely to continue. Before winter will continue. Then look at that question number fifth. They dot dot on the last stage of their journey. They set out. Set out means, yes, right, start. Start on the journey. They set out on the last stage of their journey, right? So like this you can write all the sentences in your notebook. Okay, your teacher will speak the words listed below. Write against each of a word of opposite meaning. Students, here you just want to write opposite meanings of the given words. Okay, let's see what are the words. Examples are given for you. liquid, solid, hard, soft. And the words that are given here that we have to write the answers of it. Old, new, then wet, dry, open, close, then blunt, sharp. It is regarding edges, okay? Blunt nail or sharp nail, like this. So blunt, sharp. Forget, remember. Okay, students, so this is your question and answer session is finished, and write all the question neat and proper in your notebook. Thank you for hearing.